Right now, I want to talk to you about a topic that a lot of owners avoid, and it's time to have a wake-up call with themselves. And that is when to know to give up your dog and when it's best to rehome your dog to another person. It is difficult, but here are the signs that you're on your way towards having to rehome your dog, so keep watching. Facing the reality of giving up your pet is simply something that is devastating, but unfortunately, it's sometimes the best route for you both. Our pets is our responsibility to ensure they have the best home possible. You might think it's unthinkable to imagine your dog in another home. Serious situations can arise that may lead you to realize that yours is no longer the best home for him. Here's some things you really need to think about when you're thinking about rehoming your dog or if it's best for them. Changing places or living in another home is a common reason pets get rehomed, but you should think about it before you get a pet. Maybe if you get a pet, you shouldn't get one when you're in an apartment and you probably have to switch to another apartment. Or if you're in a home and you know years later you're probably going to have to move because the lease is up, you want to make sure that you're able to find a nice stable place where your pet could come with you. It's difficult, but we need to do a little bit more pre-planning if this is happening. Having a new baby in the home forces you to push your dog out of the home. That could be very difficult, especially if your dog is not respecting the baby's space, okay? I know this is something that is hard, but if you're not able to train your dog and your dog is just all over the baby's stuff, not giving the baby space, or if it's a very serious aggression issue towards the baby, maybe it's best to give your dog up to maybe someone that's able to train it or into a shelter or some kind of rescue group. But then again, this is something to think about before you add additions into your home. You gotta know what could come out of having a baby in the home when you add it to your family, especially if you have a dog that's been there. Maybe you cannot afford to keep up with the dog's basic needs, such as food, accessories that they need, and vet care. This is another tough one because I know some people may lose their jobs, especially with the time frame that we're going through right now. It could be very tough when you lose your job or if you change jobs, or things just get out of hand. Maybe a new bill gets added onto you. I know this could be very hard as well. Maybe you could look for friends and family for help. But if you're seriously not able to afford your dog to live with you, maybe it's best to give up your dog to another owner that's able to take care of them more properly. I know it's hard, but I mean, you don't want to start starving these dogs. And you may need vet visits. They need all the proper gear they need in order to live correctly. So it's just something to think about. The inability to properly train your dog or don't make an effort to get professional help, even if they're aggressive. This is something that I see a lot of owners doing. They're not making the effort to give their dog the training that they need. To me, this is no excuse to give up your dog, but you have to make an effort. If you're not willing to make an effort and train your dog at least 15 minutes a day, then you shouldn't have that dog, honestly. You need to be able to train it at least, I'm saying bare minimum, 3 times a week for 30 minutes a day. If not that, 15 minutes a day every day to keep it nice and short if you have a tight schedule. This is no excuse to give up your dog. You should be getting help. If you can't do it yourself and you're not able to train, hire a professional. This is something that is very mandatory for every dog. Another common reason is they just don't have the time to take care of your dog. You're always working or away from home for long periods of time. And I know this relates back to what I said last time. You might get a new job and you might have to be at that job for 12 hours a day, 14 hours a day. And there's no one there to help you with the dog while they're at home. Then maybe it's time you need to give up that dog and give it to someone else that could take care of it. A rescue group, a shelter, a non-kill shelter, or a family and friend member of the family. So you just need to make time for these dogs, especially before you get the dog. You got to know that you're going to be able to create time for them, to be able to train them and make them the best companion that you can make them. It all has to involve your time and you need to put a TLC into it. Now, here are other signs that it may be time to find a new home for your pet. There might be physical inabilities to exercise them properly, inability to drive or use public transit to purchase food for them or supplies or take them to the vet. You have an injury while attempting to care for them. A depletion of energy due to medical stuff you might have going on make increasingly difficult to provide care for them. Your condition has changed your lifestyle so much that your pet is noticeably unhappy due to the lack of attention, exercise, and care that it needs. It is best to find local rehome shelters, rescue groups or even a relative that is willing to accept the dog. Avoid any kill shelters if possible. Now, I know medical conditions is none of my business to ask what you guys got, and I'm not going into that. But what I want to say is if you do have stuff going on with you, that you need to take care of yourself first before you can take care of another living object, then that is best to take care of yourself and let someone else take care of the pet, all right? I know it's difficult, but it's something we have to think about. So these are some serious signs that you need to think about if you're thinking about maybe keeping your dog is not the best for you and the dog. It's very hard and it's very difficult to think about giving up your dog, but if you can't take care of the dog, then it's best for someone else to take care of that dog that can. I know it's hard, I know it hurts, but we have to think about these because these are lives at the end of the day. These are real lives that the dogs have. They're no different than any other animal. They're animals that need a good life. Now leave a comment below. Have you had to experience anything like this? If so, I'm very sorry, but I do want to hear your story down below. I would love to respond to you and maybe we can communicate about it. But if you like this video, hit that like button below and I will see you guys on the next one. I am out.